My name is Clint Cappiello. I'm one of the pediatric surgeons at Johns Hopkins Children's Center. I also have a practice at Howard County General Hospital. We see general pediatric surgical patients here, both inpatient in the ICU and as well as in the emergency department. My area of expertise is general pediatric and thoracic surgery, as well as care of newborn infants with congenital anomalies. And I see patients here twice a month and patients downtown as well. Appendicitis is one of the most common phone calls we get as pediatric surgeons. It's probably our most common abdominal emergency in children. The appendix kind of gets a bad rap. It's a useless organ as far as we're concerned. It may harbor some helpful bacteria, but in general, it just causes problems. Appendicitis is when the opening of the appendix itself becomes blocked. The tissue on the inside continues to make bacterial turnover, cells die and have to leave, and they can't. So you imagine a water balloon that's now being overfilled. At some point, it's going to reach critical mass. The blood supply is going to be starved off, and that's when that appendix bursts. We try to catch these before they burst because the postoperative course is much less complicated in a pre-ruptured appendix. The typical appendicitis is not usual for children, unfortunately, because our young patients can't always tell us what they're feeling or how their pain is or where their pain is. So for your older kids, usually it's a bellyache that starts around the belly button and then kind of moves down to the right lower quadrant. We typically teach our residents pain precedes puke, so a kid complaining of belly pain who then develops nausea, vomiting, and not wanting to eat is suspicious for appendicitis. Now in an infant, they may just not want to move, pulling their legs up, fussy, poor appetite, diarrhea, it runs the gamut. So we routinely do surgery for acute appendicitis. There are some centers that advocate for non-operative management, but in our opinion, this leaves behind an offending organ that may be temporized with antibiotic treatment, but there is a significant rate of recurrence. So generally, on diagnosis, the patient will be started on antibiotics and brought to the operating room within the next 24 hours. The operation for appendicitis is well established. No longer do we make that right lower quadrant incision, leaving your child with a big scar. That happens exceedingly rare. 99%+ of these are taken out laparoscopically. That involves going to sleep, putting a camera usually into or next to the belly button, and then two small instruments, one between their bladder and belly button, and one on the left side of their abdomen. The operation itself can take as little as 15 minutes or as long as 2 or 3 hours. It really depends on the severity of appendicitis, the child's habitus, prior operations, or other comorbid conditions. Postoperative care for acute appendicitis is similar to other laparoscopic procedures. In the wake of the opioid crisis, we've really dialed back on how much narcotic pain medication children are using. And much to our pleasant surprise, most kids don't need narcotic pain medication. Usually Tylenol and Motrin is fine. If a child comes in the morning with acute appendicitis that's not perforated, they can be sleeping in their own bed that night. More complicated appendicitis, those that are perforated, present with an abscess or other complicating factors, may spend as many as 6 or 7 days in the hospital. For children who come in already perforated with a duration of more than 5 days and a large abscess, we'll generally treat the abscess first with a drain and then remove the appendix in 6 to 8 weeks.